What's up, y'all? Gerald here, creator of Gospel Chops and your host for this YouTube channel, back with another video. Now, if you followed the Fast and Furious saga over the many years and many iterations of the movie, you've seen our brother Tyrese Gibson develop within that series. He's gone from an R&B singer to a featured actor in the city of Los Angeles. There's a massive promotional campaign going on for Fast and Furious X, and Tyrese has played a part in that promotion. So he recently had an interview in Los Angeles with Big Boy on his radio show and talked about, well, the devil being active in the industry. If you followed Tyrese for some time, you know that God is in his heart, and you know that he's a believer. God will always leave a remnant, even in the most desolate places such as Hollywood. And in this interview, promoting his upcoming movie and album, he took this opportunity to speak about things that I'm sure were unscripted. The devil being prominently promoted in the industry. Let's take a look at what Tyrese had to say in this clip.
Gotcha. Yeah. So we got Kim Burrell.
Hey, Kim was like, you going to hell, son.
You should stop.
Kim was like,
stop right.
She was like, I don't know if the Lord know you playing or if you serious. Like, you know, I don't know if these jokes are lies, baby. You know
so
what I'm saying?
God will send you the desires of your heart.
I hear you, brother.
Right? Imagine being a motherless child. You know.
Yeah, man.
Intimately.
Yes, sir.
And then God says, I know what you desire, and I'm going to send you your mother via Kim Burrell.
I love it.
And the talks and the laughter and the bonding and the conversation that was never there. Now, people know I didn't have the best relationship with my mom. So as a son, I was longing for the relationship to be better while she was still here.
Yes, sir.
So I really started longing for that relationship once she transitioned. So God will send you all of the desires of your heart. And that is something that I want everybody who can hear this interview to know. As much as I'm supposed to be promoting this movie and talking about my album, I just feel like we're in competition right now because they are trying to normalize the devil. They are trying to populate. The devil is on the main stage at award shows and in every video and
yeah, man.
Signs and symbols. And I said, you know what? We need to stop treating our relationship with Jesus like the little buddy that you talk to before you go to bed at night and not be more vocal about all the things that God means to us and all of the things that God has brought us through. Because there's been a lot of moments that you didn't post about,
mm-hmm.
but yet you know, how did God decide to get me through this?
Yeah, man.
And yeah, they going above and beyond to promote the devil. And it's pissing me off.
Mm-hmm.
Because the devil worshipers used to be real secretive.
Oh,
like
yeah.
Going down in the basement, this secret
man.
World. Now they just
now
like,
they on the device too.
Yeah,
believe that.
Yeah.
I do want to come back and I want to talk to you about Fast 10 as well.
Yeah.
All righty. There's this movie that I wanted to talk to you about. I think you know about it.
Yeah.
All righty.
Did anybody notice that when he turned the conversation unscripted to talking about the devil in Hollywood, did anybody besides me notice how fast Big Boy went to pivot? It's like he didn't want to touch that at all. You see, there are people in Hollywood who are controlled and part of a machine, and there are people in Hollywood that go unscripted and are led by their spirit, by their belief. And it looks like Tyrese in this incident went totally off script. And Big Boy didn't know how to handle it. He said, look, let's talk about the devil being promoted here out front at award shows, in Target stores, everywhere around us. And Big Boy was like, let's back up off that. There's a movie I want to talk about. Well, Tyrese went right back to it. He said, you know what? I see how you got off that, and I know you my guy and all, but let's close out this session. Let's close out this appearance. Let's close out this promotional spot with a word of prayer. How about that? How about we invoke the Spirit of God here in this radio station right now, right here? Since I saw you take that Dodge, bruh, who's controlling you? Who's controlling this station, these airwaves? Are you a part of the machine? If so, let me combat that. I like the way he said that. He said we're in competition, but there is no competition. We're in a spiritual warfare. So it's time to mount up, y'all. It's time to put on the whole armor of God, because we are in warfare against these demonic influences that have infiltrated Hollywood and have taken the main stage in this industry. But he finished off with, bruh, I need to have my sister, my spiritual mother, come in and say a prayer. And we gonna bless this station. We gonna bless this promotional spot. And we gonna bless that attitude I just saw from you who ran from what I was trying to say. Check this part out.
Tyrese, this time went by fast. We got to do this again.
Okay.
We got to do this again, man. And like I say, bro, it's been a pleasure just knowing you as a friend.
Yes, sir.
You know, and of course, when it comes to anything that you do in your craft, bro, like, you're amazingly talented.
Thank you, sir.
You know, and I love, bro, I love the person that I've had a chance to bear witness to and watch this journey as this journey continues. You know, we met each other, bro. We didn't have kids.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
We didn't have wives. You probably didn't have homes. Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
None of that. Yeah.
Yeah, man. But the one thing that we continue to do, man, let's continue to work on ourselves too.
Yes, sir.
And I thank you for coming into the neighborhood, man.
My pleasure, man.
And you know, we're doing a Fast X. We're going to do a whole screening that's exclusive.
Just, I wonder how that happened.
Yeah, man. Well, I put it all together.
You did.
It's something that I put together.
So y'all know, for the city of Los Angeles, we have the international world premiere of Fast and the Furious, Fast 10, in Rome.
Okay? Right, yes.
Rome. It's crazy.
Go ahead,
right?
Now. Hello. Okay. Yeah, they put that around
you. Yeah, you see that? And so there was no plan to do a movie premiere for Fast 10 in L.A.
Yes, sir. Aww.
And we are exclusively doing this, Big Boy iHeartRadio in L.A. We just got the confirmation. Shout out to Doc.
Yeah, man.
Who was at it every day.
I mean, he was.
Don't downplay
something.
Doc.
I know, yeah, okay. But don't upplay him either. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I'm saying? Are you in Doc Winter's neighborhood right now?
No, I'm not.
Yeah.
But I'm sure he arranged the neighborhood. Put up a couple houses and done a couple things. Hey, Big, if you don't mind, man, because so many people in the city that we love and be loved by is carrying a lot. And like when we talk about the devil seem to be way more popular than the relationship with Christ. If it's possible, man, can I just close this interview out with a prayer from Mama Kim Burrell
to bless
the
city? Yes, brother,
if
please.
If y'all don't mind that.
Hey, brother, there's no such thing called too much prayer, bro.
Okay, thank
no
you.
No such thing called too much
Mama
prayer.
Mama Kim Burrell.
Kim Burrell.
Hello there, legendary. There's so many people who are going through a divorce and foreclosure. Homeless, they were living their best life. They got degrees on the wall. They got their whole family sleeping in sheds in downtown LA. And even if you're in mansions, the mental, emotional, psychological warfare has been real for most of us. So this is my mama right here. And I just want her to bless everybody with a prayer. Don't crash closing your eyes driving, okay? But just receive this prayer from Mama Kim Burrell. Here we go.
Dear God, thank you. You're everything to us, so you're everything through us. Without you, we are nothing. Mm-hmm. Thank you for your love. Yes, thank you for your healing. Thank you for your protection. Thank you, dear God, for your guidance. For every person that sees and hears this, do more for them, be more through them. Thank you for all things, God. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Thank you, sister. Appreciate you. Thank you, Tyrese. Thank you. Love you, my brother.
Did y'all see what I saw? I love the way Tyrese noticed how Big Boy dodged what he was trying to do and where he was trying to go with that interview. And he took it right back around and said, hey, bro, let's go back here where I meant to go in the first place. I saw your pivot, but I'm trying to get to this. Let's have some prayer. Because people are going through some things out here. And as I mentioned previously in our interview, where you obviously got triggered, this industry is promoting Satanism. It's promoting demonic entities and putting them in front of our children. This is a problem. And I'm going to use my moment in this platform to speak my peace, to declare the word of God. And since I saw your dodge in my statement, let's go even further and have a word of prayer. I love it. When I was a young videographer back in 2004, I didn't know how cameras functioned. I didn't know what I was doing. I didn't know anything about lighting. And Kim Burrell was my first celebrity interview in 2004. Never forget it. She was reluctant, but she was performing at a conference where I was working the video situation. It seemed like she didn't want to do it. But the homie, Huey Lovelady, was friends with Kim Burrell, and he convinced her to do this sit-down interview. Shout out to Huey Lovelady. And she did the interview and gave me such motivation and inspiration to keep going in the furtherance of my career. It was a blessing back then. And I'm glad to see that Kim Burrell, throughout her career, has touched lives of many, including Tyrese Gibson, who's willing to stand up for her, even in his moment of promotion for Fast and Furious 10. What did you think about his presentation? Are you feeling Tyrese's spirit? Are you seeing that despite having to operate in this demonic industry, that there's something that's been implanted within him that still lives? That fire still burns, even though he has to contend with Satan's imps every day of his career. If you feel what Tyrese is talking about, and you think that that fire still burns within him, even though he has to deal with demonic forces every day just to sustain his career, if you like how Tyrese is talking, like this video. Subscribe to the channel and share this video so we can get more people involved in the conversation, y'all. And like I always say, always remember and never forget, without the gospel, it's just chops. Until next time. Peace.